Good morning, children. Today, I will revise with you chapter number 20, that is Gautam Buddha. So, let's start. Who was Gautam Buddha? He was the son of King Suddhodana of Kapilavastu. He was a very noble and kind-hearted boy. He had a cousin named Devdatta. Both Buddha and Devdatta used to play together in a garden. Now, children, before also I told you a story about Gautam Buddha, that is, who was Gautam Buddha. So again, today I am telling you that story. Listen properly, otherwise you won't be able to answer all the questions. Okay? So there was a boy named Siddharth Gautama. He was born in Nepal. His mother's name was Maya Devi and father was King Suddhodana. He was the king of Kapilavastu. When Siddharth was only 7 days old, his mother died. So his father brought him up in a very peaceful and nice way. So one day when an astrologer predicted after his birth that if Gautam stayed inside his palace his whole life, then he would become a great king. But if he left the palace, then he would become a great religious leader. Religious means who have a strong belief in God. So what his father did? His father did not want him to become a religious leader, so he kept Siddhartha in the palace for his entire childhood days. Okay, there were home tutors also for him inside the palace only. When Gautama turned 16 years old, that is when he became 16 years old, his father found a woman for him to marry. What was the name of his wife? His wife name was Yashodhara. And they had a son named Rahul. Siddhartha had everything. Okay? Whatever he wanted, he had everything. But still he was not happy. Why? Because he wanted to learn about life outside his palace. So one day Gautama left his family and everything when he was 29 years old. At the age of 29, he left his family. He went, where he went? He went into the forest in search of peace and truth. Because he wanted to have peace. He was not happy in his palace. So, he went into the forest in search of peace and truth. He was roaming place to place to gain knowledge. So, he met many saints also. But he was not satisfied. After trying different ways to find a path of truth, that is to find a way of truth, he finally reached the city of Bodh Gaya. That is, he finally reached Bihar. At last, he started meditating. He started doing meditation, bearing physical suffering. Where he sat? He was sitting in meditation under a peepal tree in the town of Bihar. Okay, he sat under a peepal tree and started doing meditation. Okay, दैट ट्री इज नोन एज बोधि वृक्ष. ओके, इट इज नोन एज बोधि वृक्ष. दैट पीपल ट्री इज नोन एज बोधि वृक्ष. देन ही गॉट ट्रांसफॉर्म्ड इनटू बुद्धा आफ्टर गेनिंग एनलाइटमेंट. ओके, द एनलाइटमेंट मीन्स ही मेडिटेटेड देयर फॉर 49 डेज एंड आफ्टर दैट आफ्टर मेडिटेशन ही बिकेम एनलाइटेंड. हु इज एनलाइटेंड? वॉट डू यू मीन बाई एनलाइटेंड? दैट इज द पर्सन हु आफ्टर गेटिंग एनलाइटमेंट मीन्स ही द पर्सन ही बिकेम ओपन माइंडेड. ओके, ही कैन सी द वर्ल्ड विद ग्रेट क्लैरिटी. इट मीन्स ओपन माइंडेड मीन्स ही कैन सी द वर्ल्ड विद ग्रेट क्लैरिटी. ही कैन टेल विच स्टेट अ पर्सन्स माइंड वॉज. ओके, फ्रॉम दैट डे ही बिकेम बुद्धा. ही केम टू बी नोन एज बुद्धा बिकॉज बिफोर हिज नेम वॉज सिद्धार्थ गौतम. बट आफ्टर गेटिंग एनलाइटमेंट ही केम टू बी नोन एज बुद्धा. ओके, एंड एट द एज ऑफ 80, बट बिफोर दैट ही ऑल्सो शेयर्ड हिज नॉलेज विथ 5 सन्यासीज. ही शेयर्ड हिज नॉलेज विथ 5 सन्यासीज. यू कैन सी हियर इन द पिक्चर 5 सन्यासीज आर सिटिंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ हिम. ही इज शेयरिंग हिज नॉलेज विथ देम. एंड दीज 5 सन्यासीज दे ट्रेवल विथ हिम थ्रू आउट द कंट्री टू टीच हिज प्रिंसिपल्स, टू टीच हिज टीचिंग्स. ओके, हिज टीचिंग्स आर नोन एज बुद्धिज्म. ओके चिल्ड्रन, सो एंड आफ्टर दैट एट द एज ऑफ 80 व्हेन गौतम बिकेम 80 ईयर्स ओल्ड ही डाइड. ओके, एंड वी सेलिब्रेट हिज बर्थडे एज बुद्ध जयंती. यू माइट हैव हर्ड चिल्ड्रन बुद्ध जयंती इन इंडिया. ओके, एंड वी वर्शिप दिस बोधि ट्री. स्टिल टुडे वी वर्शिप दिस बोधि ट्री. ओके, बोधि वृक्ष आई टोल्ड यू दैट पीपल ट्री अंडर विच ही मेडिटेटेड. दैट ट्री वी स्टिल वर्शिप टुडे. सो दिस वॉज द स्टोरी ऑफ गौतम बुद्धा. ओके चिल्ड्रेन, लिसन प्रॉपरली बिकॉज क्वेश्चंस आई गिव क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम दैट स्टोरी ऑल्सो आई हैव गिवन. दैट्स वाई लिसन प्रॉपरली. नाउ कम टू द चैप्टर दैट इज गौतम बुद्धा एंड देवदत्ता. दे यूज टू प्ले टुगेदर इन अ गार्डन. वॉट हैपेंड वन डे बुद्धा वॉज सिटिंग नियर अ पॉन्ड and he was watching the swans in the water. Suddenly what happened? A swan fell at his feet. Okay, and he saw that there was an arrow in its body. The swan was also bleeding. So Buddha felt pity on it. He felt pity on the swan because he was bleeding. There was an arrow in its body. What did he do? Then Gautam picked up the swan in his arms and he drew the arrow out of the wound. And he dressed its wound and patted it. Patted, you know? Patted, children? Patted means when we stroke on the back. Gently. Okay, then what happened? There came Devdatta. Devdatta was his cousin, right? So he came running there and he asked Buddha to return the swan to him. But Buddha refused to give because he have saved its life and Devdatta tried to kill it. Yes, that's why he refused to return the swan to Devdatta. After that, they went to the king for justice. Because both wanted to have the swan, so they went to the king. And the king, what did the king do? The king gave his judgment in Buddha's favor. Definitely, because Buddha saved its life. So, king gave his judgment in Buddha's favor. And Buddha himself was kind. What did he taught people? He taught people not to kill men, animals or birds. That means not to kill anyone. Yes. His main teachings were love, peace and pity. We should, that means we should love each other. We should show pity on them, on others. We should never kill anyone. Okay, children. This was the story of Gautam Buddha. So, we have completed. We have revised the chapter. Next, come to the question answer part. Answer in brief. So, you have to answer in brief. You have to write the full answer. I am discussing with you as usual. Listen properly all the answers and write it down. Question number 1. Who was Gautam Buddha? Answer is, Gautam Buddha was the son of King Suddhodana of Kapilavastu. Okay? He was a noble and kind-hearted boy. His name was Siddhartha Gautama. He was born in Nepal. Got the answer, children? In the story I told you, his name was Siddhartha Gautama. So, Gautam Buddha was the son of King Suddhodana of Kapilavastu. He was a noble and kind-hearted boy. His name was Siddhartha Gautama. He was born in Nepal. You have to write the full answer like this. Okay? Next question. Question number 2. What did an astrologer predicted about Gautama after his birth? Yes, children. You know the answer. What did an astrologer predicted? Answer is, an astrologer predicted about Gautama soon after his birth that if Gautama stayed inside his palace his whole life, then he would become a great king. But if he left the palace, then he would become a great religious leader. Okay, children? Got the answer? Next question. Question number 3. What did Buddha saw near a pond? Can you give answer? Yes. It's very easy. Buddha saw a swan fell at his feet and there was an arrow in its body. It was also bleeding. Right? Buddha saw a swan fell at his feet and there was an arrow in its body. It was also bleeding. Okay. Question number 4. What does Buddha do after seeing the wounded swan? So you have to write, what did he do? What does he do when he saw the wounded swan? Buddha felt, answer I am telling you, Buddha felt pity when he saw the wounded swan. Okay, he picked up the swan in his arms and drew the arrow out of the wound. Then he dressed its wound and patted it. Okay. Question number 5. Why did Buddha refuse to return swan to Devadatta? Answer is, Buddha refused to return swan to Devadatta because he tried to kill the swan and Buddha has saved its life. Okay, children? Because he tried to kill the swan and Buddha has saved its life. Am I clear? All the answers? Yes. Next, move to answer the following question. Question number 1. What was the name of Gautam Buddha's father and mother? You have to write the name of both the parents of Gautam Buddha. Answer is, Gautam Buddha's father's name was King Suddhodana and mother's name was Maya. Okay, children? Question number 2. What were Buddha's teachings? Answer is, Buddha's teachings were love, peace, and pity. He taught people not to kill men, animals, or birds. You have to write the full teachings, what his teachings were. Okay? Question number 3. To whom did Buddha and Devadatta went for judgment? What was the decision taken by that person? That means it is a part question, children. Two questions are there. To whom did Buddha and Devadatta went for judgment? First you will write that, and after that you will write what was the decision taken by that person to whom they went. Okay? Answer is, Buddha and Devadatta went to the king for judgment. Okay? So they went to the king, and what was the decision taken by the king? You will write now. The king gave his judgment in Buddha's favor. Okay? Got it? So question number 4. At what age did Buddha got married? Can you answer the question? If you have heard the story properly, you will be able to write the answer. Otherwise not. I am giving you the answer. Buddha got married at the age of 16 years with a woman named Yashodhara. Okay? With a woman named Yashodhara. Okay? Question number 5. When did Buddha left his home and why? Answer is, Buddha left his home at the age of 29 years. He had everything he want, but still he was not happy. So he left his home to find his inner peace. Okay, children, in the story I told you, he was not happy in his palace, though he had everything he want. So he left his home at the age of 29. Next question, number 6. Where did Buddha sit for meditation? Answer is, Buddha sat for meditation under a peepal tree known as Bodhi Vriksh in the town of Bihar. Okay, children, here Bodhi Vriksh, I am telling you the spelling of Vriksh because it is not in the book. V-R-I-K-S-H-A. Okay. Question number 7. With whom did Buddha share his knowledge? Answer is, Buddha shared his knowledge with 5 sannyasis who meditated with him. Yes, I showed you the picture also. He shared his knowledge with 5 sannyasis who meditated with him. Question number 8. How do we celebrate Buddha's birthday? Answer is, we celebrate Buddha's birthday as Buddha Jayanti. Okay? We celebrate his birthday as Buddha Jayanti. Next is short answers. Here, you have to write just the one word answer. Okay, let's start. I am not going to give you the answers of these questions. Okay, so write properly. Question number 1. Who was Devdatta? Yes, I hope all of you know the answer. It's very easy. Who was Devdatta? Question number 2. Who wanted to have the swan? Who wanted to have the swan, children? All of you know the answer? Yes. Question number 3. Whom did Buddha save? Just write the one word, whom did Buddha save? Question number 4. At what age Gautam Buddha died? It's again from the story. So listen the story properly, children. At what age did Gautam Buddha died? Question number 5. Who tried to kill the swan? Who tried to kill the swan? Just write the name of that person. Okay? Question number 6. Who was bleeding? We have read who was bleeding. Write down the answer. Question number 7. How did Buddha felt on the swan? That means, what did Buddha felt? How did he felt when he saw the wounded swan? You have to write that. When he saw the wounded swan, how did he felt? Okay? Question number 8. What was Buddha watching in the water? That means when he was sitting near the pond, what did he watch in the water? Question number 9. Write the meaning of noble and patted. You have to write the meaning of noble and patted, children. That means you have to learn all the meanings of all the chapters. Always when I teach you the chapters, I always give you the meanings of every words. But at the end of the chapter, you will see there are some new words written over there. Please learn all the new words. Okay, children? So, you have to write the meaning of noble and patted. Question number 10. What was the name of the tree under which Buddha started meditation? You have to write the name of the tree, children. I told you the name of the tree. So, these were all the questions which I have given you. Just write it down in your social studies exercise book. And one more, children. In your book, take out page number 93. You will see there things to do as heading. You will complete it. There is written, join the dots to complete the pictures and color them. So, you will join it, okay, and you will color the pictures. It's the picture of a Buddha and swan. So, it's very easy. You will be able to do. Okay, children. And one thing more, children. As I have given you all the answers, start learning also. You can learn all the, you just go through the chapter again and learn the question answer also. And as soon as the school reopens, I will check it down. Okay. Thank you, children. Have a nice day.